We're back on a Saturday morning with an inspiring story about an organization on a mission to save all homeless pets around the country.
Earlier this year, Best Friends Animal Society opened its first adoption center, and they did it right here in the heart of New York City.
And it is a great spot. It marks the new beginning for the sanctuary that's hoping to encourage all shelters nationwide to be no-kill by 2025. I visited them to see how they plan on achieving that goal.
You've seen the old-fashioned animal shelter, downtrodden cats and dogs held in tiny cages, hoping for a home. The ones who aren't adopted, euthanized. The numbers are staggering. 5,500 dogs and cats put to sleep every day in U.S. shelters. But could that sad reality be changing? The people behind Best Friends Animal Society of New York City hope so. They've opened a brand new state-of-the-art adoption center helping local pets find forever homes. Elizabeth Jensen is the Society's executive director.
We want to make sure that any animal that's got a shot to get a home gets that shot.
She and her team want every shelter across the country to become no-kill by 2025. First step, leading by example. She took me for a behind-the-scenes look at the state-of-the-art center.
This facility here, this is brand new in New York. Tell me what makes it so special.
We purposely put this here in Soho, in New York City, because we wanted it to be where the people are, right? Best Friends looks at people as the solution.
First up, the cats.
Everybody in here is up for adoption.
Meet six-week-old Moose.
What a cutie.
The younger kittens are the most at risk. They need to be fed every 2 hours, and many shelters just don't have the manpower to do it.
Once we get Moose up here up to 8 weeks, he will be one of the most adoptable animals that they're out there.
Every animal that comes here has a home for life.
Hi, can you sit?
Best Friends makes a lifetime commitment to all of our animals. So if for any reason Moose's family in the future ran into hard times and weren't able to take care of Moose, Moose comes back to Best Friends. It's part of the agreement with the adoption.
Next up, the dogs.
Oh, hi, buddy.
First adoption.
Patrick and Rachel Givens adopted Chewy when Best Friends first opened.
For families who haven't adopted before, why do you think it's important to raise awareness about how great adoption can be?
This is our first time adopting, and it's just been an amazing experience. And we know, you know, Chewy probably had a rough first half of his life, but he's going to have a really strong second half and couldn't be a better fit in our family, so we're excited.
Chewy was so cute. And you may be asking how they can afford such swanky digs. Well, it's 100% provided for by donations and grants. So how does Best Friends hope to inspire the no-kill movement? Well, first they want to shift attitudes about animals that come from shelters, then educate people on how to take care of their pets that many end up in shelters simply because a family can't care for them anymore. So you want to stop that before it happens.
Absolutely. I didn't realize the numbers were so high. 5,500 a day in this country?
It is staggering, and it makes you so sad.
It does make you sad.
And dogs, they just want a home.
Talk about that was good, Dylan.
Yeah. Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.